Hi everyone. This is a little talk on Calc, which is my very first open source project. So this was done as part of the season of KDE 2021. Hi everyone, I'm Rohan Ashokan. I'm a student developer from India. Oh, I'm really sorry, the slides are pretty messed up. I think it's possibly something from the conversion. Yes, I'm a student developer from India. I'm currently a web developer too, and I'm working on a game startup. So all this started when I actually wanted to get into open source. Open source was something really alluring to me, and I wanted to jump in naturally. So the only piece of open source software that I was using back then was KDE Plasma, and naturally I wanted to do something for KDE. So I jumped in and the first thing I started doing was setting up the environment, and it took me around 3 months. I was on a Kali OS back then. I guess it wasn't the right OS for development. It took me a really long time to set it up. And once I set up, I started working on this issue that was bugging me since the beginning and was possibly one of the reasons why I wanted to come into open source. This was a search bar in Dolphin. I tried asking around. I tried looking into the code. It was pretty overwhelming. I was a complete newbie back then. I didn't know what to do or what to start. And it was pretty overwhelming. And at the end, I ended up forgetting about it. And then came season of KDE. This was something for beginners, and I was a beginner. Being a beginner myself, I was all in for doing something with season of KDE. So I worked on this project called Calc. Calc is an open source cross-platform calculator application that is built using the Kirigami framework. It has its focus on power and being lightweighted. So it's really user-friendly in that sense. And back then, the calculator had a basic calculation module, you know, addition, subtraction, and all that, including a few scientific functions like sine, cos, and the like. So what I wanted to do was add up to this already existing arsenal of scientific functions, and also bring in an entirely new binary calculation module. So I call this thing the programming mode, wherein you can add binary numbers or subtract binary numbers or do operations with binary numbers in general. And also, I wanted to see the converted outputs of this. So let's say I type in 1001 in binary. I should be able to see it in decimal or octal or hexadecimal for that matter. And I also wanted to introduce a new feature called the date calculation module. So it's really common that, I mean, I can't calculate dates, practically speaking. If you ask me what's the difference between two dates, that's really hard for me. And I tend to use a calculator. So I wanted to see how a date calculation module would fit into an application like Calc, wherein Calc was focused on power and speed and user friendliness. So my first course of action was adding to the scientific calculations module. To put it into perspective, the code base of Calc was really small. Just to say, there'll be a bunch of files that are the back end, a bunch of files for the front end, and there were some parser files. So at the most, it'll be a dozen files, and it wasn't much code. But then back then, being a newbie, I wasn't able to understand much. I felt overwhelmed by the code, and it was pretty bad. I didn't know where to start. I didn't know what to do. So I went and talked to my mentor, Hanya. She helped me out, and she pointed out to a few PRs, and those actually helped me a lot. And I figure out how to add some features, add some functions to this. And that was my very first merge request with KDE and open source in general. So I guess you could see that. So my next course of action was obviously building the binary calculation module. Compared to the previous feature, this was a massive overtaking for me, undertaking for me. And that's because it was a completely new mode and it required completely different parsers and different ways that I should flow the data. Initially, when I started working on it, it wasn't very easy to figure out where I should add, where I should change, where I should update. I didn't have that understanding of the code base. And yeah, I ended up taking an entire month digging around, searching for things, and still not understanding the code base. And then I realized that though I had a mentor and I could talk to her and figure out what I should do, obviously. So I went ahead and talked to her, and surprise, surprise, it took only 3 days and I was done with the calculator module. That was a huge realization for me. 1 month of digging around on my own and figuring out nothing, but then 3 days, I just talked to a mentor and 3 days it was done. So these are some UI pictures of the calculator module as it stands today. And at the right, you could see some calculations being made. And I guess in this version, the octal conversion wasn't being done, and it was only binary, decimal, and hexadecimal. We did a couple of operations, but the binary calculator module is currently limited to only two numbers. So you can add two numbers or subtract two numbers, but more than two numbers, currently it's not possible. That was a design decision, considering that the calculator is very lightweight. And the next thing we faced was someone actually pointed out that we were using a data C++ data type. The project was based in C++, so we were naturally using a C++ data type, which had non-infinite precision. So the precision was limited. The max I could there was a limit to how big the numbers could get or how small the numbers could get. So possibly over 10 power 24 or 10 power 20 something, I wouldn't be able to calculate with that version of the calculator. So we had to port to an infinite precision calculations in the backend. So we used something called K-number, which is part of the KDE API. And during this time, I was able to form a complete understanding of the calc module. After all this time, this was when I actually was able to form a full picture. But this was because K-number required changes in every single aspect of the program. And because of that, I was able to piece together a full image of how the data flow happened within the program. And this was pretty important going on, because I was designing a new date calculation module. And on planning about it, there were pretty much three operations that I wanted to build. These were finding a difference between two dates. So given a date in the future and given today's date, I want to find how many days are between these two. This feature would be able to do it. And next was, let's say you have a given date, that is, let's say, 21st of this month, and I wanna know what the date would be 20 days from then. So that would be the use of that feature, the add a number of days to the given date. And the subtract a number of days from the given days is essentially, let's say, 30th of this month, and I want 20 days before that. So That would give me a date that is 20 days before some given date. That was the core idea, and I started building up some UI for this. This was pretty straightforward, and I used some models and calculators from the Kirigami framework and Qt. We actually did not push this to the current version. That's because we were not sure if this would suit the user base, essentially, because Calc focuses on simplicity and ease of use. We were not sure if this date module would really fit in with that theme. Obviously, it depends on the community now. If you guys need it, we'll be ready to build it up. And out of all of this, my takeaways were quite a lot, because this was my very first experience with open source, and it taught me a lot. And I'll just put it out there, so maybe someone who is planning to get into or is scared of getting into open source could use it. So the very first thing I faced was being scared of a code base which put out that open source journey for a long time. And there's nothing to be scared of it, because when we're newbies, we don't understand how code works, how data flow works, and all that. So what one needs to do is just pick up a feature that you want to implement and start from there, instead of starting by learning the code base or something like that. So starting from what feature you want to build and then seeing where that leads you is possibly the best way to learn about a code base. And the next thing I understood from this whole experience was you really need to talk to people, and because they obviously have worked with the code base before and they know quite a lot, and they'll be at least be able to point you in the right direction. And for that reason, you really need to talk and discuss with other people. And yes, the most important of all, do ask doubts. Doubts might seem really stupid to you. Most of my doubts still seem stupid to me, but that might not be the same way other people look at it, right? So they might be able to help you with the doubt. And worst case, what might happen? There's nothing that could happen out of it. So the other thing that I learned was, especially from that experience with the binary calculator, I spent an entire month trying to figure out what to do, is that you have to look at what to do yourself, but then you have to maintain that balance of communicating with others and doing your own work. That is very important in open source, because the code bases are really huge over here. That is something I learned out of this. And thank you everyone who has been directly or indirectly part of the journey and helping me with it. And thank you. That is my talk.